Today, we will discuss the concept of Newton's second law of motion and how it relates the net external force acting on an object to the acceleration of the object. Imagine yourself pushing a box on a frictionless floor with some constant force. This applied force causes some acceleration in the object. How do you think this acceleration is related to the applied force? Let's take another situation. Suppose a fixed force is applied to two boxes of different masses. Will the acceleration produced due to the applied force be the same, or will it depend on any other factor other than the applied force? We'll find out the answers to these questions in this video shortly. Newton's second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum of an object is equal to the force applied on the object, and it takes place in the direction of applied force. Mathematically, in this formula, is the net force acting on an object. P is the momentum, and represents the change in the momentum of the object in time, dt. Where the momentum of an object is, here, m is the mass of the object, and is the velocity of the object. The direction of the momentum is same as the direction of the velocity of the object. Then the rate of the change of momentum will be, here the term represents the rate of change of velocity with time, which is nothing but the acceleration. Therefore, thus the net force acting on the object is. So, Newton's second law of motion can also be stated as, the net force acting on an object is equal to the mass times acceleration of the object, and the direction of acceleration is the same as the net force. Therefore, for a fixed mass, the acceleration will increase by increasing the net applied force. Let's talk about common mistakes. Do not think that the same applied force will produce the same acceleration. The acceleration depends on two parameters, force and mass. If the same force is applied to two different masses, then the acceleration will vary inversely with mass. That is, therefore, if the same force is applied, then the lighter mass will accelerate more as compared to the heavier mass. Let's take a real-world example. Suppose a force of 50 newtons is applied to two boxes of different masses. The boxes will accelerate with 2 meters per second squared and 4 meters per second squared. Calculate the mass of the two boxes. The mass of the two boxes can be calculated as. Now we will substitute the given values for each box and calculate the mass. Thus, the box with more acceleration has less mass as compared to the box with less acceleration. Let's summarize what we have learned so far. Newton's second law of motion relates the net applied force to the acceleration of an object. The net force acting on an object is equal to the product of its mass and acceleration, and the direction of acceleration is the same as the applied force. The concept of Newton's second law should now be clear to you. For better understanding, try some practice problems to have a good command of the concept.